Hello everyone, my name is Loco and welcome back to another StarCraft video. Now what I got for you today is a match played on one of the new maps on Port Alexander LE with the new balance changes. Spawning here in the top left hand corner of the map and playing with the red Zerg drones. We are currently looking inside of the main base of Bly. And his opponent spawning in the opposite corner. He's playing with the yellow Terran SCVs. I covered this man in a game just a couple of days ago. Of course, I'm talking about Future. Now, in that match, he went up against Cham on one of the new maps as well. And in that game, I don't really want to spoil it for you, so if you haven't seen it yet, I'll post the link to it down below in the description of this one. But in that match, Future decided to go for some very aggressive Battlecruiser play. Now, I secretly hope, and I obviously don't know, but I secretly hope that he's going to be doing something similar in this particular match as well. Now, he is going up against Bly. Bly, I've covered him in many games before. He's a very difficult Zerg player to play against. He used to be known as that guy who would basically cheese the vast majority of the matches. However, I would say over like the last year or two, he's really refined his mechanical skills, I suppose. And he's really, really good at just simply playing the macro game. But since he used to cheese almost exclusively for years and years and years, he's still one of those players who's definitely not scared to play hyper-aggressive if his opponent gives him a reason to. So I'm excited to figure out how Future decides to play against this kind of player, because it's definitely true that Bly is a slippery Zerg player to go up against. Anyways, very normal opener here from both players, although there's no factory just yet. That is something that we actually have to pay attention to. No factory just yet does mean that this is likely going to be a more marine-focused opener. Bly is sending in that Overlord right now. It looks like it's already rallied to go right near the back of the main base. Obviously, with the new maps, it always takes a little bit of time before Zerg players figure out how to rally their overlords and where they can hide them in useful positions. But there we go. This will be spotted immediately by Bly, and he will, of course, know the timing at which this barracks should be finishing up its reactor. And apparently, it is a little bit earlier than we would normally expect it. So we'll see if Bly is going to do something about that. He did get himself a couple links. They're going to be running across the map upon realizing that there is no Reaper available. Bly also decides to jump straight into the third base. So relatively normal opener here from Zerg. Only a handful of queens so far. No additional queens actually, interestingly enough. Queens obviously do now have a lower rate at which they can spread around that creep. The creep spread has been nerfed quite a bit in that regard. But finally, there we go, a third queen is coming up. So Bly decided to favor the third base over additional queens here initially. Now he did poke up into the front right there of the Terran Natural. He did see a couple of Marines. I think he saw four or so of them. Another gas has now been taken as well. Oh man, are you kidding? Is this once again? Alright, this is what I was hoping for. I think this almost has to be... I'm not sure, actually. I'm not sure on the build order where you want to go for Battlecruisers, but I'm pretty sure if you take the third gas this early on, the only reason is that you want to make something really, really gas-heavy, right? Yeah, oh, there we go. Yeah, the tech lab has been built. Future is likely gonna switch over that starport and probably produce a fusion core here in just a little bit. Can we see a fusion core? Is that... Yeah, okay, there it is, there it is. Okay, so in the meantime, by the way, the Zerg decided to make a lot of Zerglings, and I think this is due to the response of seeing that reactor and then also four Marines. That means that Terran is likely not going to be producing Hellions here for at least a little while. So Bly did make himself a lot of links. Ooh, the SCV, or rather the Marines there, are caught with their pants down. There's still four remaining inside of that bunker. The SCVs immediately pulled off the mineral line. The Zerglings are going to go to town on whatever they can kill right now. And while it does look like the bunker may very well hold, that is still a handful of SCVs that ended up falling there. And that is way more than you really want if you are a Terran player at this point in the game. Well, a fusion core is finishing up. I think this has to be Battlecruiser play. I mean, it could be Liberator range, but I don't think so. Come on, give me the Battlecruiser. Well, I mean, he doesn't have... Well, he actually does. There we go. The Battlecruiser does indeed start. Now, this is completely unscouted so far by Zerg. Bly does realize that something weird is happening, right? If a Terran player is not making Hellions, you know something odd is going on. There we do now see the Overlord sacrificing itself. it is very likely gonna see that something is... Well, no. I don't think Zerk saw anything there, but he does know that there is already a tech lab right there on that starport, and obviously that will at the very least force out these spore crawlers. So this could be Liberator play, this could still be a cloaked Banshee play, it could be a variety of units. He probably doesn't assume though that it's gonna be Battlecruisers, and I'm really curious to see how Bly is going to respond. So Cham, we saw him trying to go up to that Hydralisk Death Ball. And while the Hydras did kind of well initially, it was a little bit difficult to say whether or not that was the correct call. Now, Future did decide to immediately tactical jump in this particular match versus Cham towards the mineral line of the Zerg. Is he going to do the same once again? Oh, yeah, he is. Okay, there we go. Immediate tactical jump inside of the main base. We do see the Zerg player responding here as well with an additional spore crawler, and by pushing the queens up towards that main base as well, a whole bunch of drones do get picked off here, since now the Battlecruiser, of course, can fire and move at the exact same time. He does need to be careful though. Future is losing a lot of hit points there on the Battlecruiser. Of course, tactical jump is going to be on cooldown here, but it does look like six drones there were killed and the Battlecruiser was saved. I mean, you can't lose this Battlecruiser. If you lose this Battlecruiser, oh man, ooh, get out! Alright, well, if you lose that Battlecruiser, I'm pretty sure that's game over. The heal overtime there on the Overlord. Ooh, and I guess eventually that Viking there will be picked off as well. Okay, so here we go. Okay, so a different response from Bly. So this is what I was trying to say, right? Hydralisk absolutely got shredded. Since Hydralisk got nerfed, and Battlecruisers got buffed a lot against ground in particular, I had the feeling in that game versus Cham that Hydras just weren't necessarily the correct choice. With going for this quick Spire, I think that Bly might be going for Mutalisk, but very, very likely Corruptors. Corruptors are, of course, phenomenal against this kind of composition. By the way, the second Battlecruiser is now out as well. A third one is already coming up. There we go. Yamato cannoning down that queen, and the queen does pop. A scan will now also confirm the exact location of all of those creep tumors, and you can really see that new smart AI targeting there of the Battlecruiser helping it out quite a bit. At the same time, the Marine Tank Ball is moving forward towards that fourth base location. I love this play though. I really, really love this play here from Future. It's such a cool style. It really does show that Battlecruisers, at the very least, seem to be a really solid unit right now. But Corruptors, I'm thinking this has to be Corruptors, right? This almost has to be. Well, he actually doesn't have a lot of minerals right now, but they will likely be produced here in a little bit. Now, another Battlecruiser did just jump towards the front here. I think that's the first one after a couple of repairs. That Spore Crawler will be pushing forward here as well, but eventually the Marines are going to try and close the distance. Now, this is a really interesting fight. I haven't seen anything like this before. A lot of queens here available, as well as that Ling Bane. However, obviously, while the Ling Bane may eventually kill those Marines and then the tank as well, those Battlecruisers still remain, and the third one just joined the fray too. Yamato cannoning down another one of those queens. In the meantime, the Marines did end up dying there to that Zergling Baneling Bull, but the Battlecruisers still remain, and they're going to try and go to town right here on whatever they can shoot at. The Lynx, though, are now going for that counterattack, backed up by those Banes, but already there's a nice wall here designed to shut this one down by Future. The Spire, though, under a huge amount of threat, it does look like it will end up falling there. There we go, it does fall, but eight more Corruptors are just about to come out, and two more are already on the battlefield. So that's going to be quite a few Corruptors there available for the Zerg player. Is it going to be enough to shoo away those Battlecruisers? I think it might be. Great micro there, though. Future will end up jumping one of those Battlecruisers away. Second one also manages to zip out of there. And I don't know if the third one does have it available. No. I think that one just tactical jumped into the battle. But still, no denying that Corruptors eventually killed that. But that still was a lot of damage that Future managed to do. Bly, though, not all too fazed by losing the fourth. He's immediately redesigned or repicked another location right there for the fourth hatchery. And while I think he did lose quite a few drones there, He did decide to also remake a whole lot of those workers almost immediately. Okay, so this is cool, right? It shows you that Battlecruisers may very well be a very solid unit in this regard. Now, the 3rd Command Center has not landed just yet. The 4th CC, though, had already been produced. So I think the future is just planning to macro off of this one and maybe land it over here a little while later. But he's once again moving through the center of the map with a Marine Siege Tank Battlecruiser Bull. This is far more aggressive than we saw him play against Champ. Not sitting back here in any stretch. That's still a lot of, like, there's still a lot of Corruptors though, right? Corruptors are really good. The Battlecruisers are not nearly as good as they are against ground when it comes to dealing with air units. So here we go. The Corruptors are gonna fight once more. Yamato cannons will be activated here as well. A 4th Battlecruiser jump forward as well. But once again, the Ling Bane army is absolutely shutting down all of those units on the ground. Now, one of those Battlecruisers definitely is not gonna be able to jump back, but a lot of those Corruptors, though, are still being picked off. I mean, sure, the damage output of these Battlecruisers versus air is not that great, but you can see that still Future is getting a lot of kills. That's 24 kills there on one Battlecruiser, and it's once again gonna jump out of there. The question is, though, the Zerg macro has not been slowed down that much. Sure, a 4th base was killed, but it didn't really have that much mining there in the first place. Right now, it does look like Bly may very well be the aggressor, because he's got a lot of Ling Bane left over, and there's not really that much on the ground. Future ended up losing, how much did he lose there? 7 siege tanks, that's a lot. 7 siege tanks by the 11 minute mark is a lot of dead siege tanks. There's also, in general, not that much production, but there are 3 Battlecruisers now coming out at every given moment. Bly did decide to create a spire once again. There we go. It is actually once more at the natural. But this spire, of course, does allow him to go back towards that Corruptor plate. There's already 8 available. 6 more are just about to come out here as well. Battlecruisers, while really powerful, they're not very fast, right? Tactical jump does have a long cooldown as well, so he can't really reposition his army. And I think that Terran does not know about the fact that the Zerg is just about to overpower that 3rd base. Corruptors trying to see whatever they can get, immediately puking over that command center as well. And that does mean that it will be picked up. Now, the Corruptors will have to fight those Battlecruisers and those Marines here in just a little bit. But already, since the Zerg army is so much faster, right, the 3rd base is absolutely demolished. Cattlebruisers once again using their Yamato guns. But the Cattlebruisers, which is a way better nickname than the Battlecruisers, are being forced back now by this amount of Corruptors. And apparently Bly, after shutting down the 3rd base, is still the one who obtains the victory. Now, I actually assumed, I hadn't really seen Battlecruisers fight Corruptors just yet. I actually assumed that the Corruptors would be substantially better than they actually were here. I mean, obviously Zerg, they fight in numbers, right? It's really doable for Zerg to just simply make 20 of the same unit at once, and then all of a sudden overpower, for example, Battlecruisers. But still, in smaller numbers, I really did feel like the Corruptors probably were gonna do a better job than they actually did. The Battlecruisers really do seem to be quite decent when it comes to dealing with small amounts of units there. And obviously Future in this particular case was caught with his pants down. He left that 3rd base completely undefended. I think he probably could have dropped down the 3rd command center at the 3rd much sooner. And then maybe follow it up with a 4th base after having a bit more of an established army. I'm also curious whether or not Marines are actually the correct addition to Battlecruisers. I mean, what if you go for like Hellions instead, and then maybe follow it up with some additional Thors? I'm not entirely sure. There's so many questions that I've got about the new patch, but it's really exciting to see that Battlecruisers do have their place in the meta. Now, I do hope that you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, make sure you hit that like button down below, and if you want to see more, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you get a notification as soon as I upload more. A special shout out to the Patreon supporters. You guys are awesome. Thank you very much. But for now, I want to thank you for watching. Have an amazing day. Do not forget to smile, all right? And I will see you once again in the next one.